ID itself. Quickly moving to the technology concepts of the web experience factory. So when we talk about creating a project or understanding the structure of the web experience factory, it is majorly done using three components, which are builders, models, and profiles. So what are those components? Here, as you can see, builders basically are adaptive reusable components, which can be Java, which can be XML. Now, using these reusable components at the runtime, it generates different code based on the profile you have applied. So a profile is a set of parameters that vary builder inputs to dynamically generate unique versions of the portlet. A profile, you can map it with the department roles, department groups, type of user agent, like your smartphone, your tablet, or the desktop browser. So based on these profiles, these builders can behave differently and can generate the code or the UI differently. Now, the combination of builder and profile becomes a model. So a model contains multiple builders. Builders capture design intelligence and automate the creation of code. So what you have to do, you have to choose a builder. I want to use this specific builder. And after choosing the builder, you have to just go through the wizard-like interface where you will provide the input. And at the end of the process, when you want to publish or run the project, it will automatically generate the code for you. Let's map these builders to some real life examples. As you many of you have already seen that these are the pieces, right? In childhood, children used to play with these kind of games where they have got the blocks. They have to join these blocks and create some meaningful objects. Now here you can compare these bricks as builders, which can help you to implement low or high level patterns. So one pattern could be like this. Using those bricks, we have created one object, right? So it's an application. You can define it as a model as well. So this is a model. This is a model. This is an application which can be created using those builders. It is just the way you have defined to place those builders. Or you can create a different object using the same builders. Now, if you just think over here, at a low level, you are not redesigning a brick. We have not redesigned or created the new bricks. What we have done is we have just restructured those bricks, the low level components which we have created earlier, right, to in such a manner that we can create a different layout or different experience for the user. So this is how the overall process works in terms of web experience factory. First of all, you have collection of builders. Now these collection of builders can be out of the box provided, which are 100 and plus builders, which are provided with web experience factory, or you can write your own builder. It is very simple to write or to create own builder. Now on this collection of builder, we have created one model. When we apply this model along with the profile, then it can give different output. Now if we say that the profile is sports person, then we can see that we get the output like this one. But if we say the profile is of traveler, then the output could be like this. So as you can see, the builder and the code which we have written is the same, but it automatically on the runtime identifies that what is the profile, and based on the profile it can define the output. That is how it increases the delivery time and reduces the development time. So it, in the same manner, it automates frequently occurring development tasks. So what you have to do, you have to create the design pattern for once, you have to create the builder, you have to create the model once. Now based on the model or the all the builders, you can define that what is the output you are looking for. So the same piece of the code can be used multiple times. As I said earlier, Web Experience Factory provides you 100 and plus Portlet Factory builders. These are in factors of generate user interfaces, SOA, Ajax technology, REST capability, Gojo frameworks, widgets, mobile themes, WCM enhancement, and CMIS integration. Using these builders and the models, you can create service-oriented architecture, or what we call as SOA. Here, as you can see on the left-hand side, these are the back-end connectors or the builders which are connecting your application to the database or to some other back-end data sources. On the front-end, you can have presentation builders, or you can have UI customization builders. The presentation builders will define that how the application or the piece of the information is going to look like, while the UI customization builders will help you to achieve the Web2.0 functionality or the rich UI functionality. It also helps you to define the layout in the runtime itself. So now, if the same application has to be extended to the mobile or the smartphone or the tablet, what we have to do, we have to just add on one more builder, which is builder for mobile UI. And now once this is installed, we can then say that use the profile for the mobile devices, which is a smartphone. And now on the runtime, it will automatically convert the UI as per the mobile UI theme. So I have got a question. Can I install this factory tool in all type of OS like Mac, OS, etc.? Yes, you can very much do that. You can use it on Windows, you can use it on Linux, you can use it on Mac OS. So now let me just move to the next slide. So what is model? Model is nothing but a set of the builders. So when we put so many builders together to create a model or to create a process, that is called as a model. Now on top of a model, we can apply the profiles. So what is a profile is, you can relate it to like variations can be related to roles or the groups. So if you have different roles like administrator or the salesperson or the IT admin or the HR, finance, so these are the different roles, or you can say them as a groups. Groups can be defined like the different departments have the different groups. So for each role or for each group, you can have a different piece of information displayed. Using profiles, what you can do is you can generate multiple applications. So you write the code once. Now on that particular code, you apply a profile or say HR profile, and then you say deploy. So for the HR profile, it will deploy the application. It will change or it will append or it will edit the code on the design time or on the run time. Same way for the different profiles, you can have different UI available. Profile selection, profile can be mapped using group membership of portal or LDAP, or you can define it based on the user attributes like the username and password, and then can map it to some other database or your file system based on the locale. So you can have different profiles based on the locale. So if it is a Indian, you can have a different profile, maybe the Hindi profile. If it is a Gujarati, then you can have a Gujarati website or the Gujarati display along with the Gujarati font getting displayed on the UI, a J2EE role, or any custom criteria. So if you have some specific system custom criteria where you want to define the application behavior based on those custom criteria, yes, you can do that. So it regenerates the code, software code based upon the inputs passed to the builders. It's similar to the process of recalculating a spreadsheet. So it is just like we generally write code in different technologies where we provide inputs to the methods or the functions, and based on those inputs, it gives you one output. Same way, the process is here. You define what is an input. As an input, you give it the profile or the role or the group, and based on that input, it will identify that what is the output or the UI or the information it has to show. So as you can see over here, putting it all together, you can have different profiles like your sales VP, sales manager, sales rep, and then you have a different models available. Now this regenerating engine will take these two inputs, match these two inputs, and will create multiple instances on the runtime. So if a salesperson is logged in, he may see the first application, the very first application on the right hand side. If it is a management person, he might see the second output. Or if it is some other role, then he might see a different data available on his portal or the application. I just got one more question. The question is, any application designed using WEF can be import and alter in any IDE like Eclipse, etc. As I said earlier, yes, Web Experience Factory WEF is also built on top of Eclipse, which is Helios. You can export this application and import this application in some other tools, but there will be few limitations, because as the way I'm explaining you, the features of the builders and the models are provided by WEF only. So if you will try to export these and import this, the code will be there, but you will not be able to customize it the manner you can do in the WEF. You can certainly export this application, you can have the source code with you, you can import that source code into some other, yes, you can very much do that. I hope that answers your question. So moving to the next slide. As a Portlet Factory component, there are two components. One is the developer tool, which is the portlet factory or the web experience factory designer. Till the 7.0, the factory was called as a portlet factory. With 8.0, the latest version which has been released, it is now called as web experience factory. So you might heard this name written on, you might heard this or read this name on some pages. So don't get confused. Portlet factory and the web experience factory is the same thing. On the server side, it requires component which is called as the runtime technology, which is bundled with the IBM portal server. It can also be deployed on the IBM WebSphere application server.